properly equilibrium long run part 3. Look at this graph. It illustrates long run monopoly equilibrium. It is called suboptimal scale equilibrium because the monopoly firm is operating on the falling side of the long run average cost curve LAC and the plant curve ACAC. There are unutilized productive capacity and economies of scale. See this diagram. It also exemplifies long-run monopoly equilibrium. It is called optimal scale equilibrium because the monopoly firm is operating at the minimum point of the LAC and ACAC curves. It means the firm has used the full productive capacity of the plant and enjoy the economies of scale in full. These two possibilities have already been discussed by me in my earlier videos. I have given the links for these two lessons for the benefit of those who didn't view them so far. In this lesson, we are going to see the third possibility, that is beyond optimal scale equilibrium. The monopoly firm can be in equilibrium and operate on the rising side of the LAC curve and still enjoy supernormal profit. It is the market condition which makes such a thing possible. The market condition is given by the AR and MR curves. LAC is the long run average cost curve. LMC, the long run marginal cost curve, cuts the MR curve from below at E. At E, the plant's short-run marginal cost curve SMC also cuts the MR curve from below. Moreover, the SAC is tangent to LAC at point F. Thus, all the long-run equilibrium conditions of a monopoly firm are satisfied. Look at point F. It is exactly below point E. It is on the rising side of the LAC curve. Again, at that point, SAC is also increasing. Point F lies to the right of the minimum point of SAC and the LAC curves. From the SAC curve, we can learn the firm is larger than optimal and overutilizing its productive capacity. From its LAC, we can learn the firm suffers internal diseconomies of scale. Such an equilibrium is popularly known as beyond optimal scale equilibrium. This kind of behavior on the part of monopoly firm is quite common in the field of public utility companies operating at national level. Well, it should be understood, even here the monopoly firm stands to earn supernormal profit. We shall see how. Monopoly output is M units. Equilibrium price is P. Total revenue is OPTM. Total cost is OSFM. Supernormal profit is SPTF. In short, what is to be understood is that in the long run, depending upon the market conditions, a monopoly firm can operate either on the falling side or minimum point or rising side of the LAC curve and be in equilibrium and enjoy abnormal profit. Our discussion on long-run monopoly equilibrium ends here. We shall meet soon with new lessons.